Hi, my name is Dean Dalton.
And I'm Tate Patterson.
And our project is the automatic door handle sanitizer.
Here's us. Now on to what's important.
This is a demonstration of a sanitation cycle. The device uses UVC LEDs to sanitize the surface. UVC light is light that has a wavelength of 200 to 280 nanometers. The LEDs that we are using have a wavelength of 270 nanometers. UVC light has been proven effective at killing viruses and bacteria on surfaces. This is why we are using it for our sanitation device. The device consists of two main parts, the UVC arm and the component housing. The UVC arm applies the UV light to the door handle surface. It consists of an LED array that contains the UVC LEDs and standard UV LEDs. Because the 270 nanometer wavelength of the UVC LEDs is invisible to the human eye, we're using these other LEDs just to show where the light is applied to the door handle. The component housing contains a stepper motor, which is driven by a current amplifier that rotates the UVC arm around the whole surface of the door handle. It also houses a passive Pir sensor that is used to detect movement from up to 10 feet away. This is used to pause a sanitation cycle. UVC light can be hazardous when there are large amounts of exposure. The Pir sensor will pause the sanitation cycle so that there is zero exposure and so that the door can be used normally. The device also has a user interface that consists of status LEDs and a push button that is used to pause and resume system functions. The whole system is powered by a 9-volt battery. This is a demonstration of the Pir sensor.
Our microcontroller is controlled by some basic firmware. First, our status LED shows the current state of the system. It will be either solid or blinking, green or amber. During a solid green, it will be waiting. During a solid amber, the system will be paused. A blinking green will be a standard cleaning cycle, while a blinking amber will be a forced cleaning cycle. The cycles themselves are either standard or forced. A standard cycle can be interrupted by the IR sensor, while a forced cycle cannot be. The system relies primarily on timers to control the cycles. After a cleaning cycle has occurred, it will wait for roughly 15 minutes before trying to perform another standard cleaning cycle. If this is paused or interrupted by the IR sensor, then it will wait for about 30 seconds before trying to operate another cycle. While it is waiting, the button can be pushed to pause the system. If 2 hours have passed with no successful cycle being performed, the system will force a cycle. The button on the system will pause everything. When the button is pushed, a standard cycle will no longer operate. When the button is pushed a second time to leave the paused state, a forced cycle will occur, after which standard operation will resume.